Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Dennis Prager Show. You really are. And you know, whenever I tell Christian guests that they're a gem, they don't know what to do with it. when I tell Jewish guests they're a gem, they go, go on, go on. Christians, they cringe. Oh, not me. Who is he talking about? Oh, my friend Barry. You know?
It was a very enjoyable conversation with you, very stimulating, I think, intellectually.
Well, it was for me. Why don't you address that one? Because time flies on these hours. Why don't you address the issue of there is the verse in Exodus? I don't expect you to know it by heart, but if you could quickly turn to it, I don't know if you have a Bible in front of you. It's a very complex verse. Does it imply that there is capital punishment for the death of a fetus, or only for the death of a woman?
Let me read it. Exodus 21:22.
Yeah, listen to it, folks. Listen carefully, because it's the only reference, direct reference, I believe, in the Hebrew Bible. I know Jeremiah says God knew us in the womb, but that's a separate issue. To the worth of a fetus. Go ahead.
When men strive together and hit a pregnant woman so that her children come out, but there is no harm, that is, if there's a premature birth, but nobody is hurt, the one who hit her shall surely be fined. And that means you endangered life, but there was no harm, but there's still a penalty. But if there is harm, Exodus 21:23. Then you shall pay life for life, eye for eye, tooth for tooth. Dennis, as you know, in the other laws given by Moses, if you accidentally cause the death of someone, such as you're out in the woods and chopping with an axe and the axe head flies off and hits someone, you don't have to pay with capital punishment with your life. You flee to the city of refuge
right.
until the high priest dies.
Right.
But here is the only time in the Mosaic laws where accidentally causing the death of an unborn child or a pregnant woman is punished by death. It's the only time. So what it's saying is that it's a higher penalty in the laws of Moses for accidentally causing a death of someone, higher penalty when you cause the death of a pregnant woman or her child than when you cause the death of anyone else in Israelite society. And it seems to me, therefore, that God is placing a higher premium on protecting the pregnant woman and her unborn child than on anybody else.
I have to say, I've been teaching the Bible, specifically the Torah, for 30 years. I have it on 250 CDs, every verse. It took me 20 years to do that. And when I taught this, I have to say, you have given me, I think, the simplest and therefore the most coherent. I always believe the simplest explanation is the correct one. And I think that is exactly what it says, and is not what I taught. I was ambivalent. When I taught it, I said it was the most ambiguous verse of law in the Torah.
Well, Dennis, there were translation issues having to do with the Hebrew text, but when I researched that in depth at one point, I found that people who were translating it another way, so if you cause a miscarriage and the child dies, you just pay a fine, the major argument in favor of that was, oh, there's a similar law in Hammurabi's law code. It wasn't really following the meaning of the Hebrew words, and so, as you know, the text of the Bible can differ with Hammurabi's law code and other secular law codes at many points. And I didn't think that was a good argument for a translation.
Right.
So it seems to me that the translation that says if you accidentally cause the life, you cause the death of this unborn child, you're subject to capital punishment. It's a very serious legislation.
And in any event, your point is excellent. It's the only accidental homicide that you pay a life for.
That's right.
Yep. Even no, whatever read you have.
Yeah, because these are men fighting together, and they
yes.
should have noticed that she was there.
That's right. Yes, that's right.